Yeah, everyone, very warm welcome to the class. Very good evening. All right, so let us begin our session today, right? So today we are going to do a very quick revision of the important concepts of your ecology. All right, so this is Dr. Saranya talking to you, and we are going to revise together very quickly on your ecological concepts. Alright, so if you are new to me, I am happy to introduce myself. I am Dr. Saranya, and I have completed my PhD with good papers, 13 papers of good impact, right? And now I have been into teaching for the past 10 years. Yes, yes, and yes, Aparjita, welcome to the class. Very good evening. Alright, come on guys. So let us learn today these important concepts, right? So if you take off with your ecology, what are the major repetitive topics? Yes, Arun. Yeah, Richa. Very good evening. Right. So one of the major topic is Aarti. Right. So one of the major topic that keeps on repeating, it is about your, what is this? About the habitat, and that too about the forest. Yes. So you will be getting questions something like, what is happening in your tropical forest? What is happening in your temperate as well as your Arctic zone? Yes, Mayank. Yes, everyone. Come on, come on. Very good evening. Yes, Gaurav. Happy. Right. So the first thing that we are going to learn is about the different zones of the forest. Right. If you take your tropical zone. Yes. All right. Yeah, Neelima, Shweta, Chanda. Very good evening. Right. This tropical zone, it is located at the height somewhere between your 20 degrees. It is at the latitude. That is the height. Yes. Average temperature is quite high. Yes, so that is going to be greater than, you are 24 degrees centigrade. Yes, and your tropical forest, they do come under this region. And you might be knowing that this tropical zone, it is going to be the most protective region. Yes, because you get quite amount of good temperature, good rainfall also. Yes, yeah, Sheila. Yes, Perumal. Yes, everyone. Come on. So it is all having all the favorable conditions, isn't it? So obviously, if the conditions are favorable, then it is going to be a good zone for your productivity. Ecological productivity is quite high with your tropical zone. Yes. Next, it is your subtropical zone, and then comes your temperate. Yes, and finally your Arctic and Antarctic. All right, and in between, you have all your deserts and that. So they are all with your very little of your productivity. All right, yes. So this is a very important information that you should know. And if you take them with respect to the rainfall. All right, so if you take them with respect to rainfall, who is getting the maximum rainfall? See, the maximum rainfall is obtained by whom? By your tropical forest. Absolutely, your tropical forest, they get up with a very, very good amount of rainfall. Right. Next, in the other way, your coniferous forest. So coniferous forest is coming under which fellow? It is coming under a mix of your tropical and your temperate. Yes. So that is going to be your coniferous forest, right? And in between you have your temperate forest. Yeah, yes, Shubham. So your grassland and desert, they get little amount of your rainfall. Yes, fine. And then your Arctic, absolutely, right? So all these are the different ranges of the rainfall, right? So this question was one of the recent question, right? So you have to match them, the name of your temperate grassland with the geographical range. So shall we just give a try with this question, right? So what is this Asia's temperate grassland called as? Yeah, Umarani. Welcome to the class. Right. Come on, guys. So what is the grassland that is present in Asia? Yes. Asia, what it is called as, the grassland? It is going to be none other than your Asia steppes. Right? All right. Fine. What about your North America? Yes, North America grassland is what? Asia, it is going to be the steppes. Very good. And what about your North America? Yes, Pratiksha, yeah, Chanda. Your North America, it is going to be none other than your prairies. Yes, we are learning this right from our 10th standard. Yes, North America, it is going to be your priorities. Right, yes. And then what about your South America? South America, it is going to be your Pampas. Right. And then your South Africa. Yes, your Africa, it is going to be your belt. Right. Okay. So the correct answer is going to be your option B. All right. Yes, absolutely, absolutely. Right. So this is one such probability. Another one, see here. This is also very simple. Which of the following option, it is listing your ecosystems in increasing order of your plant productivity? Yes, yes, Pratiksha. Which is the increasing order of your plant productivity? So which one will be which is better? Yes. Yes, yes. Which is increasing in order of your plant productivity? Yeah. Come on. Yes, everyone. So, who is going to be which is listing your ecosystem in increasing order of your productivity per day per unit area? So who is most productive? Yes, who is most productive? Most productive is going to be who is with highest productivity? Come on. Highest productivity is going to be your tropical. Absolutely, tropical is the highest productivity. Least one, it is going to be desert, isn't it? Right. Yes, absolutely, we're all right. So which is listing in increasing order of the productivity? So it should start to increase. Right, absolutely. So lowest one, it is going to be desert, and then your temperate, and then finally it is going to be your tropical. Yes, got it? Absolutely. So your option B is going to be the right one. All right, fine. The next one, it is the important rules. Yes, yes, come on. So the important rules, right? So the rules of your ecology, right? Yes, Rupak, of course, B is right. So the important rules of your ecology, right? Yes, Rupak, B is right. Yes. So the first important rule, it is going to be your Gloger's rule. All right. So what is the Gloger's rule telling about? It is telling that, yes, yes, but number one. Yes. So this Gloger's rule is telling that, yes, in terms of your surface area, yes, Kartika, what is the difference between your temperate grassland and your temperate forest? Sure. So if you take up your temperate grassland, yes, we will just take this diagram. Yeah. So see here, this is going to be your temperate forest. Yes. All right. So I'll just put this slide such that your doubt will be done. See here, this region is called as your temperate forest. This region, which is overlapping with the grassland, this is called as your temperate grassland. Got it? Yes. So now what is the difference? It is all dependent on your rainfall. See, in your temperate forest, the rainfall is pretty okay. But in your temperate grassland, how is the rainfall? The rainfall is going to be still less. Got it? All right. Come on, guys. So let us make a move towards your next one. Right. So I was telling you about your Gloger's rule. Yes. So the Gloger's rule, it is applicable only to your warm-blooded animals, right? Yes. So it is only applicable to your warm-blooded animals, right? And what it is happening with these animals? See here, if at all the animal is staying in a very cold region, what will happen? In normal, you don't think of size. In general, if at all your animal is staying in a cold region, it has to serve or it has to preserve your heat. Am I right? fine. But if at all your heat is moving off, right? So your heat is being displaced, then it is going to be very tough for the organism, right? Actually, the volume is going to produce the heat and your surface area is going to spend the heat, right? So it is like your money. Yes, volume is going to earn the money and your surface area, it is going to spend the money. Got it? Right. So that is why if your income is greater than your expense, you are good. Isn't it? Right. That is why your expense should be less. So the amount you spend should be less. Isn't it? That is why you see your surface volume, your surface area is equal to your expense. Right. And your volume is going to be your income. Right. So if your expense is less, then you are very good. Isn't it? The same thing. Your surface area or your expense should be least. See here, if the size is large, what is happening to your surface area? It is only 2. If the size is small, the amount of expenditure is going to be 6. Right? So you are decreasing your expense by increasing the volume. Right? Yes. So your surface area is to volume ratio, it is going to be lower in case of your bigger organism. Yes, absolutely. And it is higher in case of your smaller organism. That is why your Bergman's rule, yes, your Bergman's rule, it is always, you know, favoring about this bigger size. Right? Especially, you know, with your warm-blooded animals. All right. Next, that is about your Bergman's rule, right? So the second rule that we were seeing is about your Allen's rule. So the Allen's rule, it is all about this external appendages. Yes, there is a volume issue, right? So it is an external appendages. So what do you mean by an external appendages? Whenever you are going to the cold places, you could have felt that, yes, your hands will chill off first. Yes, all your external appendages, whichever is exposed, it is going to chill off first. Am I right? You have experienced that? That is why, you have the fireplace where you will be keeping your hand in the fire and you will relax a bit. Absolutely, isn't it? Right. So all your external appendages, they are going to get cold soon. So what they are doing as per your Allen's rule, all the external appendages, they are going to get short, right? Yes, shorter external appendages. So let it be the ear, let it be the limb, right? So everything is going to get short. So that is going to be your Allen's rule, right? So we are done with the Bergman's rule. We are done with the Allen's rule, right? Fine. And these are the very, very important rules. So let us take up this question. A general increase in the average body mass of the animal population within the species is called as what? Yes, so which has led to an increase in your body mass within a species? Right, it is going to be none other than so it is increasing your body mass. Yeah, it is none other than your Bergman's rule, right? Allen's rule, it is telling only about your appendages, right? So this is gone, right? Very good, everyone, right? And Hamilton rule, it is about the benefit and the cost. So it is nowhere related here, right? Yes. You just try to refresh, huh? So you try to refresh the screen. All right. Yes, yes, absolutely. So it is going to be your Bergman's rule. Bergman is with the size. Okay. So the key important term in the Bergman is size, or your surface area is to volume ratio. All right. Yes, yes. Refresh, refresh, everyone. All right. So the second one. Yeah. The second one, it is going to be your Allen's rule. Allen's rule is about your appendage. Your appendage is becoming shorter. Yes. And Hamilton rule, it is an altruistic behavior. right? So it is your RB is greater than C, right? Your relationship and then your benefit and the cost, that is going to be your Hamilton's rule. Clear? Right? Okay, done. Yes. So apart from that, yes, Arunraj. Refresh, Arunraj. Yes, kindly refresh such that no, you will be getting it.
So that is,
yes, just a minute, even I have a volume issue also. Alright, right, so we are done with the Bergman's effect. Yeah. And one more rule I wanted to discuss. Yes, it is called as your wrench rule. What is this wrench rule? Wrench rule, it states that the birds, if they are present in your colder, oh yes, definitely. So the wrench rule, it is telling about, no, the colder areas. If at all the birds, they are present in the colder areas, how they are behaving? They are having a very, very narrow wing, right? So that is going to be your wrench rule, right? So what is your wrench rule telling of? Your wrench rule is telling that if at all your birds are present in the cold areas, they are going to have a shorter wing. Yes. So it is going to have a narrow wing. Yeah, when compared to the warmer region. All right. So the one more rule, it is called as your Jordan's rule. Yes. So what is this Jordan's rule is telling about? Huh? Right. So your Jordan's rule is telling about the vertebra. Okay. Right. So what is that saying about? See here, the fish, or I mean the cold water fish, right? Yes. So the cold water fish, it is having more vertebral column. Okay. So if at all your latitude is increasing, so your temperature is going to decrease, right? So if the temperature is going to decrease, then it is leading to more number of vertebra. All right, fine. So these wrench rule, Jordan's rule, Allen's rule, Bergman's and Glauger rule, they are seriously, you know, very important rules for your ecology examination. All right, yes. So let us keep moving. Yes, come on. Hey everyone, so I think this is all clear, the different rules. All right, so we will see the important terms now. All right, yes. So apart from that, what you should revise definitely, it is your NIC concepts. Yes. So what is the difference between your habitat and the NIC? Yes. Habitat, it is referring to the place where actually your organism is actually staying, right? It is something like your address, right? NIC is not only the address, it is all telling you about your occupation, your likes, your dislikes, everything is coming under a NIC, right? Fine. So that is the major difference between your habitat and the NIC. Yes. So under the NIC, yes, NIC is more specific, isn't it? Right. So under the NIC, yes, you can take your house, right? So this is your house. All right. Yeah. So if you take your house, the total house is called as your fundamental NIC, right? Fine. So do you stay in all the places of your house? No. Majorly you will stay probably in your own room, or else you take your college, your university, the total university is there, but you are going to stay in a specific place, right? So that becomes your realized, yes, it is going to be a realized NIC, right? So that is where actually you are staying, because that room is meant for you, isn't it? Right. So that is the realized NIC. All right. Fine. So one more law is there relative to that. It is called as Gauss law of competitive exclusion. What do you mean by competitive exclusion? It says that no two species, right, with NIC overlap, right, they can coexist. That means they will not coexist, right? So no two species with an overlapping NIC, it cannot coexist. So what they should do? They should divide among themselves. Yes, it should say that, okay, I will use this room, you go to this room, right? Such that you will not have any fight for the resources. Got it? So this is what is called as your resource partitioning, right? Sometimes it may happen like your character displacement. Yes. So Gallopogeus finches, that is the best example for your character displacement. Yes, absolutely. So what is happening? Huh? So certain birds, they go off with eating the seeds. Certain they eat the insects. Certain they eat the fruits. Right? So it is certain or eating the worms. So accordingly, the adaptive radiation is taking place and you know the beak, it is changing. Got my point? Right. So these are all the important terms that you should be aware of while you are doing a revision in your ecology. Got it? Yeah, right. So this is all clear. What is a fundamental snake, realized snake, competitive exclusion, resource partitioning, character displacement? These are all the keywords. Right. So you observed that two species of barnacles, all right, the species 1 and species 2, right? In a minute, I'm sorry, I'm hiding it. All right, fine. Right. So you have barnacles, the species 1 and species 2. All right. So they occupy the upper and the lower strata respectively. All right. So only when species 2 is removed by you from the lower strata, the species 1, it could occupy both your upper and lower strata. From the choices given below, what would be your inference from these observations? Come on. So this is the rock. All right. Yes, initially what is happening? Your species 1 is occupying your upper region and species 2 is occupying your lower region. Right. Fine. And then you are removing the species 2. Now your 1 can come and happily reside here also. Right. So what is the correct one? Yes. Come on. Yes, one answer is correct. Come on everyone. See what I told about the fundamental neck. Fundamental neck is going to be your total house. Yes. Right. What is the realized neck? It is your room. So in your house, if nobody is there, then you will be sleeping in the hall. True or false? For instance, I am telling. Right. So nobody is there in the house. So you will happily occupy any region of your house. Got it? Yeah. So absolutely your answer A is going to be correct. Yes. So the species 1 can survive throughout this rock. So that is that upper and lower, both of them, you got my point. This upper and lower both together, it is the fundamental nick. Got it? Right. But your species 2, it is having an overlap with species 1. Right. Because of which your species 1 is restricted to stay only in the upper half. It is a competitive exclusion. And this becomes the realized, nick for the species 1. And this is going to be the realized nick for the species 2. Now you remove the species 2, so your 1 can come here. That means that this total is this fundamental neck and upper is going to be the realized neck without any kind of this thing. Got it? Right? So which is going to be your correct answer? Yes, absolutely. Your option A is going to be the correct one. Fine. Yes, everyone. I hope that this is all now clear to you about what is a fundamental neck and what is going to be your realized neck. All right. Come on. So let us make a move towards your next question. Yes. Two species of crab. Yes. Very good, everyone. So they are the species 1 and 2. Yes. So they are occupying your, I am hiding. Right. In a minute. Fine. All right. Yes. So two species of the crab, right? Your species 1, yeah, species 2, it is going to occupy your upper and lower strata. Yes. your population of your species 1, it is higher on the upper rock as compared to the species 2. Okay, so it is hinting something. In an experiment, each species was excluded to see the effect on the other. Right, so when the species 1 was excluded, the species 2 did not go to the upper rock. Right, but when the species 2 was excluded, the species 1, it spread to the down. Right, so what is going to be correct? Yes, so now which is going to be the correct statement? Come on guys, you got the point? You have your upper and lower. Okay, yes, so in your upper, one is more, yes, and two is less, right? Yes, good, good, come on. So now what is happening actually? Even if you exclude 2, your 1 is able to come down. But you are excluding 1, right? But 2 did not go up. 2 didn't want to go up. So, your species 2's, absolutely. Got it everyone? Yes. So, the realized nick of your species 2 is very same as that of your fundamental nick. That is why even you remove the species 1 also, it is not able to climb up, because this is its fundamental nick, this is going to be its realized nick also. Got my point? So your option A is ultimately going to be the correct one. All right, now a final question. Right, yes, still we do have to discuss your MacArthur principle. Let us see, your time is very less. Right, so the following are your nick characteristics of the species and resource partitioning in your different ecosystem. So which of these will lead to competitive exclusion of species? All right, so see, which is leading to exclusion? So where your competition, yes, it is going to be very, very high and it is leading to exclusion. When it will happen? When you will exclude them? Yes. Why not 4? Yes, Chandan, definitely we will discuss. For the last question? Alright. See, you want to exclude. If there is an exclusion, yes, there should be your nick overlap. Right? So here, only this region is overlapping. This is all free. So it will coexist. Here also, this region is free. So it will coexist. Here it is totally free, it will coexist. But if you say take this B option, both are overlapping. If they are overlapping, they cannot coexist. Yes, so that is why your option B is correct. Alright, so someone was asking about this question. So your fundamental nick of species 1 is same as that of a realized nick. No, for the species 1, the fundamental nick is going to be both the upper and the lower. That is the fundamental. And what is the realized nick for the species 1? It is settling in your upper rock. So that is going to be your realized nick. Got it? Yes, yes, I think someone was asking for this. Yes, Chandan, I think you got it now. Alright guys, yes, absolutely. So the correct answer here is going to be your option B. Why option B? I told you that there should be a nick overlap such that your species is excluded. It will lead to the exclusion of the species. Whichever is strong will exist, the other will be excluded from that region. Yes, that is, I'm sorry, that is why, you know, this is going to be correct. All right, got it? Oh my god, time is flying like anything. I wanted to discuss a lot. All right, so very briefly, your MacArthur principle. It is a graph that is speaking about your colonization rate versus your extinction rate. Yes, two major principle in your mark author. What is that? Number one, it is based upon the size. So larger the size, yes, thanks a lot everyone, right? So if the size is going to be very large, then what will happen? The species richness is more, right? And if your distance is going to be very, very short, yes, if your distance is going to be very, very short, then only your species richness will be high. Yes, you can see that. The number of species present, yes, it is going to increase only if the size is increased and the distance is decreased. Alright guys, so we have come to the end of the class. We are running out of time. Alright, maybe we will meet out in yet another session and we will discuss all these concepts. Right, so happy learning everyone. Your NET examination is very, very close. So start studying very nicely, start practicing. And definitely I will help you out with my wonderful courses at Unacademy. Yes, so by these courses you will be able to cover up all the 13 units. You will be able to practice the MCQ with detailed solutions like this. Oh yes, and then we do have revision series, test series, doubt clearance, and there will be a live poll where you can practice. All these you get at a package at 10,500 for 1 year. Yes, and you can use my code Saranya Live to get 10% off. Currently we are doing with molecular interaction and almost it is getting over. Yes, from 19th I am beginning with the fundamental process, a very, very important unit for your exam, right? And then I'll be doing developmental biology. Anyhow, if you take the package, you know, you will get all the 13 units along with your part A. Everything is covered. Oh right, thanks a lot everyone. So this is the fee charges, and if at all you are a new student and you want to learn from the scratch, I highly recommend you to go for 24 month package. It is very economically benefit also. It is just 12,600 for 2 years. Yes, yeah Julie, now the time is reduced to 30 minutes, right? So I have no option left. yes, right. So all the very best. Probably I will catch you soon. Yeah everyone, take care, keep learning, bye bye. Yes.